Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our SV series flow sensors. In today's video, we are going to go over the programming of our SV series flow sensor. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our SV series flow sensors. In today's video, we are going over the programming of our SV series flow sensors. In this section, I wanted to show you where we go over some commonly used terms in our menu structure. Here we go over the definitions of these terms. For example, HNO, HNC, FNO, and FNC are the different switching output settings used for output 1 or output 2. So now let me take you to the sensor itself and show you how to manually program it using the display and push buttons. In this video, I am going to be programming an SV4200. This specific part number has a G1 half-inch process connection. However, we have other options available with different process connections. To begin, I want to show you our colored display for our SV sensors. On the display, you can see the flow rate and temperature on the main screen at once. I'm going to show you how you can change the units of your flow rate, as well as show you where you can change the different settings for your output 1 and output 2. So to begin, I'm going to take you into the menu. You go into the menu by pressing this enter button. In the main menu, you see your SP1 and RP1, which is your set point and reset point for output 1, and you see SP2 and RP2, which is your set point and reset point for output 2. If we go into the extended functions menu by going to the EF and pressing enter, here you can see RES, which is how you can factory reset this sensor. You see further information on the SV4200, and you see your configuration menu, memory menu, and display menu. I'm now going to take you into the configuration menu by going to CFG and pressing enter. Here you have your output 1 and output 2 parameters, which is where you can set your output settings, which we talk about in the programming section on the Learn More page of our SV sensors. Next, you have other settings you can set, but I want to show you where you can set your units, which is the UNI parameter. If you press enter at UNI, it'll take you into this parameter. And if you hold down either the up or down arrow key, you'll see the bar begin to load. And when it loads all the way, you can toggle through your different options. So for example, liters per minute or cubic meters per hour. So I will set it to cubic meters per hour by pressing enter. Next, I wanted to show you where we have the SEL2 setting. And this is where you can set output 2 to either monitor flow or temperature. So now if I go back into the extended functions menu, I also wanted to show you the display menu. So if you go down to DIS and press enter, in this menu you can change your layout of the main display so you can have it show either just flow, just temperature, or flow and temperature like it currently does. You can change the update rate of your display, you can change the rotation of your display, you can change the brightness, and then you can also change the color for flow and temperature. So for example, I'm going to go into the rotation and press enter. Here you can hold down the up or down arrow key, let the bar load, and you can set it for a different rotation. So I am going to flip it upside down to show you by pressing enter on 180. So now if I go back to the main display, you can see that your display is now rotated, and it is also showing in cubic meters per hour. So there you have it. That concludes this Tech Insights video on the programming of our SV series flow sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.